Greetings. I was having a discussion with a Christian brother some years ago, and out of the blue he asked, "Well, don't you believe sin sends a person to hell?" And the following came to mind. John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." And I'm pretty sure this is one of the most famous verses in the Bible. But how many of us have read past this verse and then cogitated on it? John 3:17, "For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believes on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God." Notice in verse 17, Jesus did not come to judge. In fact, Jesus did not need to condemn you. If you don't believe, you are condemned already. And this is the condemnation. Get ready. This is the reason you are condemned. That light is come into the world, and men loved darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. Funny. It does not say, because you sin or because you sinned. But certainly that is a related component of it. Read it again. "And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men loved darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that does evil hates the light, neither comes to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved." It is the shame of getting caught. Think about that for a moment. How many confessions say, "Sorry I got caught doing"? That is very different from "I did wrong" or "I was wrong." But he that does truth comes to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they were wrought or worked in God. And I think that was a moment for me to better understand John 3:16 through 21. But is there more to understand? I know I wanted to think sin did send us to hell. And researching this point, I turned to Romans 6. And as I kept going back, then to Romans 5. And it is just too much for one video. So maybe later I'll do a Romans 5 and 6 video. But here are some high points. Romans 5:18. "So then, as through one trespass there is condemnation for everyone, so also through one righteous act there is life-giving justification for everyone." Notice, life-giving justification. This one righteous act was the one action by Jesus. And please notice, this says everyone. It does not say the elect. Romans 5:20, "The law came in so that transgression would increase, but where sin increased, grace abounded all the more." Boy, that sounds screwy, doesn't it? The law came, the law was given to increase sin? I hate to leave this unaddressed here, but save that question. Okay, I can't. If there is no law, there is no breaking the law, or there is no sin. We needed the law to reveal our sin nature. God redeems us from our sin nature. But our flesh still likes the feelings of sin. Think of the root of the word sensual. Our senses like the sensations, the feelings of sins. Hebrews 11:25, "Choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. This is talking about Moses. Make no mistake, sin is pleasurable. Consider why a paradise of sin would entice men to martyr themselves. The lure and trap of eternal sensual pleasure. Romans 6:12. Therefore, do not let sin rule your mortal bodies so that you obey their desires. Your body has desires, cravings. Romans 6:13. And do not go on presenting your members of your body to sin as instruments of unrighteousness, but present yourselves to God as those alive from the dead, and your members as instruments of righteousness to God. You, meaning you the Spirit, need to control your body. And you are now able to because of sharing Christ's death. And sin has no authority over you, for you are not under the written law, but under grace. And I've addressed before, do Christians have license to sin? Romans 6:22, but now that you have been freed from sin and have become God's slaves, the benefit you reap is sanctification, and the result is eternal life. For you Muslim brothers and sisters, Christianity is the only way you can truly become a servant of God, because Almighty God first sets you free from slavery to sin. That is why you struggle, brother, to try and be a good Muslim. But beyond being only a servant or slave, God adopts you to become a friend and child of His. This is the true Injil, the message that Jesus brought. Anyway, I'm getting off track a little, but I think you must have needed to hear that. Getting back to the original point, sins, individual acts, are not what condemns you to the flames of hell. It is rejecting the gift and the offer from the Son of God. John 3:18. He that believes on Him, on Jesus, is not condemned, but he that believes not is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men loved darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. Do you love the light, brother? Or are you in fear? What you do will come to light. If you will accept the gift of the Son of God, He can set you free from the power sin has over you. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.